Morning, Vananda. Today we are going to discuss about the problems on transformer. Okay, this is also previous year problem. Okay, a single phase transformer has a voltage ratio of 6:1. Okay, therefore the single phase transformer has a voltage ratio is 6:1 and the HV winding is supplied at 540 volts. Okay, that means it is the V2. Okay, the HV winding is supplied. That means it is V2. Therefore, V2 is equal to 540 volts. Therefore, V2 is equal to 540 volts. Okay, first write down the given data and then which parameters we will be calculated, and then what are the formulas that will be related to finding that parameters. Okay, after that we calculate that unknown parameters. Okay, the voltage ratio is 6:1. Okay, therefore the voltage ratio is 6:1, and the secondary winding provides a full load current of 30 ampere. Secondary winding provides a full load current means it is I2. Okay, therefore the secondary winding provides the full load current, that means I2. Therefore I2 is equal to 30 amperes. Okay, understood ma? Therefore I2 is equal to 30 amperes. Next, at a power factor of 0.8 lagging. Okay, therefore, what is meant by power factor? That is cos phi. Okay, what is meant by power factor? That is cos phi. Therefore, cos phi is equal to 0.8 lagging. Therefore, cos phi is equal to 0.8 lagging. Neglect losses. Okay, first bit, find the rating of the transformer. Okay, neglect the losses and then first we find the rating of a transformer. Okay, what is the rating? The transformer is rated in KVA. Okay, first we the transformer is rated in KVA. First of all, we determine the KVA for that transformer, that is KVA rating. Okay, second, the power supplied to the load. Okay, therefore, second bit is the power supplied to the load. Okay, what is the units for that power? That is kW, that is output power, that is output power. Units for that output power is equal to kW. Okay, therefore, the power supplied means the output power. Okay, its units is kW. Next, we determine the primary current. Okay, what is meant by primary current? That is I1. Okay, therefore the primary current is equal to the I1. Okay, this is the three determined parameters. First one is the rating of a transformer. Okay, the rating of a transformer means the KVA. Next, the power supplied to the load. Okay, therefore the power supplied to the load means KW are the output power. Next, we determine the primary current, that is the I1. Okay, understand? Next, we determine the primary current, that is the I1. First of all, okay, in this problem, we are giving the voltage ratio, that is 6:1. Therefore, first we determine the V2, V1. Okay, in this question, V2 is there, that is 540. Okay, therefore, the voltage ratio is 6:1. Then, how we will determine the V1? Therefore, V1 is equal to 6 × V2. Why? Because means the voltage ratio is 6:1. Therefore, how we will determine the V1? Therefore, V1 is equal to 6 × V2. 6 × V2. Okay, therefore V2 is equal to 540. Then we obtain the V1 value. Okay, what is the V1 value when we are multiplying with the 6 × V2? Its value is 3240. Okay, therefore V1 is equal to 3240. Okay, next, what is the formula for KVA? First bit is the KVA. What is the formula for determining that KVA? Okay, therefore KVA is equal to, that is the rating of a transformer. Therefore KVA is equal to V2 into I2. Therefore KVA is equal to V2 into I2. Okay, therefore what is the V2? 540. Therefore what is the V2? That is 540. Therefore 540 into, what is the I2 current? That is 30 amperes. Therefore 540 into 30. Okay, that is the KVA rating of a transformer. Okay, therefore this will be equal to 15,000. That means 15 KVA. 15,000, that means 15 KVA. Okay, this is the first bit, that is the rating of a transformer. Okay, this is the first bit, that is the rating of a transformer. Therefore the formula for KVA is equal to V2 into I2. Therefore V2 is equal to 540 and I2 is equal to 30. Then we obtain the 15 KVA. Okay, that is the rating of a transformer. Okay, next we determine the second bit. Okay, what is the second bit? That is KW, or the output power. Okay, the power supplied to the load, that means the output power. Therefore KW is equal to KVA into power factor. KW is equal to KVA into cos phi. Okay, this is the formula for finding the KW. Okay, we remember those formulas, that is KW is equal to the KVA into cos phi. Then this will be equal to, okay, what is the KVA? That is 15 KVA into cos phi. Okay, what is the cos phi value? That is 0.8. therefore cos phi is equal to 0.8. then we obtain the KW. Next, what is the last bit? That is I1. okay, what is the third bit? That is I1. I1 means the primary current. Okay, what is the third bit? That is the I1 current. Okay, what is meant by the I1? That is the primary current. Okay, therefore formula for determining the I1 is equal to the KVA by V1. Okay, we are having the formula for finding the I1. That is equal to KVA by V1. That is equal to KVA by V1. Okay, how much amount of KVA that will be obtained? That is 15 KVA. That means 15 KVA by V1. V1 is in volts, that's why it is also converted into the VA. Therefore 15,000 by V1 is 3240. Okay, by V1 is equal to 3240. Then we obtain the I1 current. Therefore I1 is equal to the primary current. Okay, this is the third bit, and this is the second bit, and this is the first bit. Okay, in that first bit, the rating of the transformer, that is KVA. Okay, therefore KVA is equal to V2 into I2. Next, second bit is the output supplied to the load, that is KW. Okay, therefore KW is equal to KVA into cos phi. Next, third bit, I1. Okay, what is the formula for I1? That is the primary current. Therefore, I1 is equal to KVA by V1. Okay, understand ma? I1 is equal to KVA by V1. Okay, this is the procedure for determining the rating of a transformer and output of a transformer and the primary current. Okay, understand ma? Next, coming to the second problem, a single phase transformer, okay, a single phase transformer has 400 primary and 1000 secondary turns. Okay, understand ma? A single phase transformer has 400 primary turns, means N. Okay, turns in the transformer, that will be indicated by N. Okay, therefore the primary turns means the N1. Okay, understand? The primary turns means the N1, that will be equal to the 400. Next, the secondary turns, that is N2. Okay, what is the secondary terms? That is N2. Therefore, N2 is equal to 1000. Therefore, N2 is equal to 1000. And N1 is equal to 400. And N2 is equal to the 1000. Next, the net cross-sectional area of the core. Okay, therefore, the net cross-sectional area, that is A. Therefore, A is equal to, therefore, A is equal to 60 centimeter square cross-sectional area, that is the A. Therefore, A is equal to 60 centimeter squares. Okay, if the primary winding to be connected to 50 hedges supply, that means F. If the primary winding is connected to the 50 hedges supply, that means F is equal to 50 hedges. Okay, understand ma? Therefore, F is equal to 50 hedges supply at voltage. Okay, what is the voltage? That is V. Okay, therefore, V is equal to the 500 volts. Okay, what is the voltage? That is V. Therefore, V is equal to 500 volts. Primary winding voltage means V1. V1 is equal to 500 volts. Next, we determine the, what is the first bit? We determine the first bit, that is the peak value of flux density in the core. Okay, what is meant by the flux? That is pi. What is meant by the flux density? That is B max. Therefore, the first bit is equal to the B max. Next, second bit, okay, what is the second bit that will be determined? The voltage induced in the secondary winding, that is V2. How we will be calculate the voltage induced in the secondary winding, that is the V2. Okay, that is the V2. Okay, understand ma? These two terms are to be determined terms. Okay, what is the formula for finding the B max value? Okay, therefore, we are having the EMF equation for the transformer, that is V1 is the primary voltage, V1 is equal to 4.44 pi F N1 into phi R B max into A. B max into A. Into B max into cross-sectional area A. Okay, this is the EMF equation of a transformer. Therefore, in this question, we are having the V1. Okay, what is the V1 value? That is 500. Okay, in this question, what is the V1 value? That will be equal to 500. Therefore, 500 is equal to 4.44 pi, instead of pi, we are considering as the B max into A. Okay, instead of pi, we are considering B max into A. Okay, in this brackets, we write down pi is equal to, pi means the flux, pi is equal to B max, therefore B max is the flux density, B max into cross-sectional area A, okay, into cross-sectional area A. Therefore, 4.44 into F. Okay, what is the supply frequency F? That is 50 hedges into N1. Okay, what is the N1? That is the primary number of turns. Okay, therefore N1 is equal to 400 and B max, that will be determined turn. Therefore, we determine the B max value into cross-sectional area A. Okay, what is the cross-sectional area? That is 60. Then it will be converted into meters. Therefore, 60 into 10 power minus 4 centimeter square. Okay, therefore, it will be there in the centimeters. Then we multiplied with 10 power minus 2. But it is there in the centimeter square. Therefore, 60 into 10 power minus 4. Okay, then we easily determine the B max value. Okay, in this given equation, only the unknown term is the B max. only the unknown term is the Bmax, then we easily determine that Bmax value. Okay, then we easily determine the Bmax value. Okay, understand ma? Okay, this is the first bit. Okay, this is the first bit. Next, coming to the second bit, what is the second bit? The induced voltage in the secondary winding. How we will be calculate that induced voltage in the secondary winding? Therefore, the induced voltage in the secondary winding is V2. Therefore, V2 is equal to 4.44 F N2 into Bmax into cross sectional area A. Bmax in cross sectional area A. And then what is the F? That is supply frequency. Therefore, what is the V2? That will be determined term. Therefore, V2 is equal to 4.44 and F. Okay, what is the F value? That is 50 hedges. Therefore, F is equal to 50 hedges into what is the N2 value? That is number of turns in the secondary. Okay, therefore, N2 is equal to 1000 into Bmax is the determined term in the previous equation. Okay, we substitute that Bmax value into cross-sectional area that is already given in the question, that is 60 centimeter square, that is 60 into 10 power minus 4. 60 into 10 power minus 4. Okay, this is the Bmax value. Okay, in this equation, the only unknown term is the V2. The only unknown term is the V2. Okay, this is the second bit. And this is the first bit. Okay, this is the procedure for calculating the maximum flux density and the secondary voltage in the transformer. Okay, understand now? Okay, next coming to the third problem. A 30 kVA, 30 kVA means that this is the rating of a transformer. Okay, therefore the rating of the transformer is 30 kVA, that is 30 kilovolt amperes and 6000 by 230 volts, that means V1. Okay, therefore, V1 is equal to 6000 volts and V2 is equal to 230 volts and supply frequency F. Therefore, F is equal to 50 hedges. Therefore, F is equal to 50 hedges. Single phase transformer has HV and LV winding resistances. The single phase transformer has HV and LV winding resistances. That is, R1 is equal to 10.2 ohms. Okay, therefore, the R1 is equal to 10.2 ohms. And then, R2 is equal to 0.06 ohms respectively. Okay, therefore, the equivalent leakage reactance as referred to the HV side. Okay, that means X01. Okay, therefore, the equivalent reactance, that is X0 referred to HV side, that means the primary. Why? Because HV side is primary, the voltage is 6000 by 230 volts. That is step down transformer. That means HV to LV. Therefore, the primary is the HV and secondary is the LV winding. Therefore, the reactance, equivalent leakage reactance referred to the HV side is 34 ohms. Okay, then find the voltage to be applied to the HV side. Find the voltage to be applied to the HV side when the LV side is short circuited. That means VSC. That means we determine the short circuit voltage. That is VSC. Also estimate the full load percentage voltage regulation. That is percentage VR. That is the full load percentage voltage regulation of a transformer. Okay, therefore we determine the percentage voltage regulation VR. Okay, and then the power factor, that is cos phi. And then the power factor, that is cos phi. Therefore cos phi is equal to (0.8) lagging. Okay, therefore the cos phi is equal to 0.8 lagging. Okay, therefore, What we will be determined, that is the VSC and the percentage voltage regulation. First, we write down the formulas for that VSC. Okay, therefore, VSC is calculated by using this formula, that is I1 into Z01. Therefore, I1 into Z01. Next, what is the formula for percentage voltage regulation? The formula for percentage voltage regulation, that is percentage VR. Okay, therefore, what is the formula for percentage voltage regulation? That is I1 into R01 cos phi. Plus X01 sin phi by V1 into 100. Okay, this is the formula for percentage voltage regulation, and this is the formula for short circuit current. Okay, first we determine the short circuit voltage by using this formula, that is I1 into Z01. Okay, first of all, we calculate the I1 value. After that, we calculate the Z01. Okay, what is the formula for I1? What is the formula for I1? That is, I1 is equal to KVA by V1. Okay, therefore, I1 is equal to KVA by V1. Okay, what is the KVA? That is the rating of a transformer. That is 30,000. That is 30,000 by V1. Okay, what is the value for V1? That is 6,000. Okay, what is the value for V1? That is 6,000. Then we obtain the I1 current. Okay, then we obtain the I1 current. Okay, therefore 6 by 30. Then the primary current is 5 amperes. Therefore, that will be equal to 5 amperes. Then we obtain the primary current, that is I1 is equal to 5 amperes. Okay, next we calculate the Z01. Okay, what is the formula for Z01? That is square root of R01 square plus X01 square. Okay, what is the formula for Z01? That is square root of R01 square plus X01 square. Okay, what is the R01? X01 is already given in the question, that is 34 ohms. Then we determine the R01. Okay, what is the formula for R01? Therefore, R01 is equal to R1 plus R2 dash. Therefore, R01 is equal to R1 plus R2 dash. In this question, there is a R1. Therefore, we are calculating the R2 dash. Okay, what is the formula for calculating the R2 dash? That is K into R2. That is K into R2. Okay, what is the K value? That is the transformation ratio. How we will be calculated that K? Therefore, K is equal to V2 by V1. Therefore, K is equal to V2 by V1. Okay, after calculating the K value, then we calculate the R2 dash. Okay, after calculating the K value, then we easily calculate the R2 dash. Okay, therefore, K is equal to 6000 by 230. Therefore, K is equal to 6000 by 230. Okay, then substitute K value in this equation. What is the R2? That is 0.0016. Okay, therefore, R2 dash is equal to K. Okay, what is the K value? That is V2 by V1. Okay, therefore, V2 is equal to 230 by V1 is equal to 6000. Into R2. Okay, what is the R2 value? That is 0.0016. Okay, this is the R2 dash value. Then we calculate this value, then we obtain the R2 dash value. Okay, after obtaining this R2 dash, okay, we calculate the R01. Okay, therefore, after obtaining the R2 dash, we calculate the R01. Therefore, R01 is equal to R1. Okay, what is the R1 value? That is 10.2 plus R2 dash. Okay, therefore, this is the R2 dash value. Okay, after determining this R2 dash, we substitute in this formula, then we obtain the R01. Okay, after obtaining the R01, then we easily calculate the Z01. Therefore, what is the formula for Z01? That is square root of R01 square plus X01 square. X01 is already given in the question, and R01 is, this is the R01 value. Okay, after obtaining this Z01, then we easily calculate the VSC. Okay, therefore, what is the formula for short circuit voltage? That is VSC. Therefore, VSC is equal to I1 into Z01. Okay, therefore, I1 value is this. That is KVA by V1. And Z0 value is this. Then we easily obtain the VSC value. Okay, after calculating that VSC, then we calculate the percentage voltage regulation. Okay, what is the formula for percentage voltage regulation? That is percentage VR is equal to I1. Okay, what is the I1 value? That is 5 amperes, 5 into R01. Okay, this is the R01 value, and cos phi is equal to 0.8. Lagging means we are considering as the plus, and X01 is that already given in the question, that is X01 is 34 ohms into sin phi. Okay, by using this cos phi value, then we calculate the sin phi. How we will be calculated? Okay, in the question, the cos phi, that is the power factor. Therefore, cos phi is equal to 0.8. Okay, by using this cos phi value, then we easily calculate the sin phi value. That is, phi is equal to cos inverse of this answer. Okay, therefore, phi is equal to cos inverse of this answer. Then we obtain the sum value, that is approximately 36.66 phi value. Okay, therefore, when we are calculating this sine value, then sine of this answer, then we obtain the sine phi value. Okay, therefore the sine phi value is equal to 0.6. Okay, therefore the sine phi value is equal to 0.6. Okay, then we substitute that sine phi value and the V1 value in this voltage regulation formula, and then we easily obtain the percentage voltage regulations. Okay, we understand, ma? First of all, before solving these problems, okay, we remember this formulas. Okay, that is Z01, R01, R2 dash, K formula, and I1 current and percentage voltage regulation and percentage efficiency. Okay, understand? Okay, this is the procedure for calculating the Okay, we continue in the next class. Okay, thank you.